supported a multi-billion-dollar industry. It's a multi-billion-dollar industry. And it's well run. It creates a lot of jobs, a lot of income to the country. Not only that, they support tourism as well. My points of courage really are honorable. Minister is clear about the international organizations which are there. I don't know if the rules of FIFA allow people to steal and take office. So I'd like to know if that is the rule FIFA have, that if you steal, you can still be office. If what I know is that most countries have also run sport through their laws. And while we are a member of FIFA, we are not really regulated by FIFA in terms of the laws of this country. FIFA equally respects the laws of this country. That's also one doctrine which must be understood. The issue of being banned. In fact, if the minister wanted to be the most popular minister, if you ban all sports associations right now, you'd be the most popular minister in this country. And work on a proper development plan. Right now, there is no proper development plan that you can talk about. So to me, the question is, what development plan does ZIFA have in terms of football? In this year, and what I'm asking, in the first year, we are going to do this. In the second year, we are going to do this. Because all these great nations that achieve a result, and the Honourable Minister is a good example of a top athlete. She knows that there was a program. She had to do so much at a certain time, do so much at a certain time. So why, in her wisdom, does she think that sports can develop without a proper plan? There's absolutely no proper plan, and it is the responsibility. And this way I seek clarity again. It is responsibility of SRC, which is mandated to see how these sports are being run. SRC has got that responsibility because it deals with all affiliates. The question is, what is the mandate of SRC in ensuring that these associations are compliant? And one of the issues of complying is to produce financial statements. If you don't produce a financial statement, Mr. Minister, you know that you are banned by SRC. Because it is part of the regulation of you being affiliated to them. So how many associations in this country, ZIFA, when did they last submit? And this is my question. When did ZIFA last submit their financial statements to SRC? If they did not, they are not even supposed to be functioning because these are audited reports which they look at and so forth. So we cannot blame the administrators when there is a law. We must now look at those who are responsible for enforcing the law, whether they are enforcing the law or not. And I think the regulations are very clear on that. In terms of section 13 of the SRC, I think it was just a slip of the tongue. You know that I'm very eloquent and particular, it was just a slip of the tongue. No, I went to the university. So, the issue is, in terms of the body, I'm glad that Honorable Philip Chiangwa is here. The minister knows that FIFA did allow ZIFA to face whatever action as long as they involve Honorable Chiangwa, who's a member of COSAFA, because he would report to them. And knowing that, and we have got Honorable Chiangwa here, he's well connected at that level more than most African people with FIFA. So we are quite protected in that regard. And they gave mandate that he be part of the team with the SRC to dissolve this. So this came from FIFA. And I would like Honorable Chairman, who's here today, to talk to this as well. I hope you can contribute on your appointment by FIFA on how football should be handled here. I hope that's so to me, what is the minister's position on that? Because when it went to FIFA, FIFA then agreed that yes, you can do whatever you want as long as one of our members is involved, and they seconded Honorable Giambo, if I'm not mistaken, to be part of the process of cleaning up Honorable Minister, it is absolutely a shame for this House to allow people who have violated the laws to continue in office. Our law of oversight does not allow us to do that. Grants have been given, they've not been accounted for. The issue of submitting yearly statements, SRC, have not been done. What are they still doing in office? So they've realized that the system is weak. As a result, they're just pilfering money every day. They're pilfering money. Honourable Minister, you don't have to worry that football, because it's a black sport, they'll say to you, you're being racist. Administration is administration, whether black, Indian, coloured, all we want are the rules to be followed. And be protected by your conscience as a sportsperson, that the good of sport in this country can only happen through good governance of sport. And there is no good governance of sport. And I implore you, Honourable Minister, that what would Zimbabwe lose by being banned by FIFA? We are always losing every day anyway. Our associations have no money, number one, to be able to protest. So it will give us some breathing space to find money, to put programs in place, and for us to look forward to what will happen. So the only thing that we have done, we have allowed people who are criminals to go into sport, steal money. It's the same as cricket, it's the same as rugby, and so forth. The entire sporting structure in this country has been destroyed because of people who are out there getting money, because our administrators are weak in terms of enforcing them. In terms of the stadium, my clarity with the minister is that, are you now in total control of all the stadiums? Are you now in total control in terms of all the stadiums, or just national sports stadiums? Are you in control of Barberfield? Are you in control of Paris Stadium, the Chitungwiza Aquatic, which is there, the Lubebe Stadium? All these stadiums, are you in control of the hockey stadium? Are you in control of it again? So I would like to know, in terms of that, how far does your mandate go? Is it just because there was this havoc and now it's been given to you and we are more or less being reactionary rather than cunning? I've always lobbied that the sports facilities must fall under sport and public works must maintain them at the end of the day. I see the money that you have been given, 23 million for the National Sports Stadium. I don't know, was it US dollars or it is part of this money where the inflation is eating it and the rate is changing and so forth. And Honorable Minister, is it enough? Is the money that you've been given enough to be able to repair this stadium? I think you did indicate that there are also other things which are needed by CAF in terms of the ticketing system and so forth. And you did say that it's not in place. So why, Honorable Minister, don't we just take our time, make sure that things are done properly, and with the respect that we have in sport internationally, we can start lobbying from other agencies that can bring in proper money and so forth. The other issue in terms of the stadium is that, what other plans do you have for the stadium? Is it just football, or intend to also have a program of event management that will be able to, so that you can sustain, so that you can earn some revenue by having them out to churches, the political parties, and so forth? What plans do you have in terms of ensuring that there's some revenue which is being earned and so forth? Lastly, Honorable Minister, I want to once again ask the question on the sporting policy that this government has pertaining to soccer? What policy do they have pertaining